name can be called Emmanuel. God is with us. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and the Bible says that he came to his disciples there in John chapter 20 and said he breathed on them. Breathed on them and said, receive ye the Holy Ghost. Oh, just close your eyes and lift your hands toward heaven and just say, breathe on me, Jesus. Oh, breathe. Jesus, holiness has nothing to do with Jesus. Oh, all the promises of God in Him, yea, amen, in the name of Jesus. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Breathe on.
God is still God. He is like
be. He's forever real. He's forever powerful. He's forever available. All we got to do is get tuned in, right? Praise God. The power of God hasn't diminished. But I remember a message, Brother Frank Spidey. I asked Mac this morning. I said, Brother Mac, is there a Church of God preacher, old time preacher by the name of Frank Spidey? He said, yes, sir. I said, he and my dad were good friends. Brother Mac's dad was a pastor, in Bristol, and a state overseer. He was a great man of God. I wish I could have met him from what I hear from Mac about him. But Brother Frank Spidey was preaching at the Tennessee camp meeting. Oh, and they were, man, usually there was no air conditioning. You know, we just had to let the wind blow through. And it always was in the third week of June. And right down there in Chattanooga, right there, right out of Cleveland, going into Chattanooga, in that area. And it got hot in the summertime. And us preachers back then, we thought we had to wear a three-piece suit and a necktie. You know, I don't know why. I told my wife, I said, if I ever get to be state overseer, I'm going to have all necktie. But now look here, it's happening. Don't have to wear a necktie. It's in style now, not that one, right? But anyway, God bless you. If you love to wear one, that's wonderful. Amen. God is a good God, isn't he? He loves us. He loves us. He don't love what we put on, what we take off, but he loves us because we're his sons and we're his daughters, and we've got to be different. If we was all the same, well, look. We was all the same. You look just like me. You don't want that to happen. Look, if we were all the same, you'd look like me. You'd talk like me. You wouldn't like anything but ice cream like I do. Right? But anyway, you know what I'm saying. It would be a boring world. Right? Everybody was the same. We're different. But oh, he was preaching on the power of prayer. And I just wanted to remind you that God is answering prayer. God is moving. We are praying and we're not going to stop praying. Amen. We're going back to sort of a semi-regular services on Sunday night. Young people are getting ready for our Christmas program. And but I've asked Brother Richard, Keys, and Leslie, to do something. We're going to start doing this about our prayer requests and prayer needs. We're going to do on the last Sunday of the month. Yeah, that's what we're going to do. See, we always have communion on the first Sunday. That's sort of a tradition. Sometimes we have to waver a little bit with it, but we've been trying to keep with it pretty much. But on the first Sunday of the month, we'll have communion service. Have the Lord's Supper, you know, sometime before the service ends. But on the last Sunday of the month, I'm going to get volunteers that will take a notebook. Brother Neil's helping me get that notebook together. We've got every Sunday in the month of November in that notebook. Richard Keith is going to take it home, Leslie. They're going to take part of our communion set home with us. And they're going to be praying this week over every name that's on that whole month, the whole month list, and every name that's put on there. They're going to be praying over that as often as they desire to, every day, every other day. However, you know, God needs them to do it. There'll be prayers going up, and they'll be probably taking communion. I'm asking if they would maybe take communion, pray over the communion set, pray over the upcoming service for the communion. Be. And I believe that's going to keep our fire burning. Amen. God's going to keep our fire burning because it takes everybody working together. Amen. You know, God don't need any hitchhikers. You don't need to hitchhike on somebody else's victory. You need to have your own victory, right? Praise God. And with everybody praying and seeking God, and we're keeping these names up in the prayer list, I believe it's going to be a blessing. So I'm going to be asking for volunteers. Jim and Nudd, Richard, volunteer today because of the time for the show, but next month we'll be looking for volunteers to do that, okay? That's just on the last week, between the last week of the month and the first week of next month. So next week he'll bring that book back, he'll bring that communion feast back, and we will have a great time in God. Amen. And prayers will go up. But prayer works. Prayer works. We was in that camp meeting in the 70s. And oh, Brother Frank's fight, preaching like only he could do it. Praise God. Brother Matt can see him. Brother Matt can hear him. You may have some tapes at home. I know Sister Green probably no doubt remembers Brother Frank's fight. Great, great man of God. Great, fiery preacher. But he was preaching, and he would stop and tell some stories, you know, of his ministry, of his pastoralship back when he was a younger man. But he said, I believe in South Carolina or North Carolina, one, he was telling about the story of one of his members. He said this member, I believe his name was Tom. But anyway, he said this member was a farmer. And this farmer had a large family. And the family, back in those days, you know, maybe you came from a large family. Usually, back in the family farm tradition, you know, it was good to have sons and daughters because, amen, the Bible says, you know, you're blessed if you have your quiver full of kids. Some preachers say, you just shoot them in the kitchen, you know, say, go in there and get me bring me a bologna sandwich out here or something, you know. Or shoot them out there in the barn and tell them to go out there and feed the horse, feed the cow, all that kind of stuff. But anyway, that's the way it was for this gentleman. His name was Tom. I remember him saying that. But he was a prayer warrior. He was a wonderful man of God. He'd been saved for years. But he believed that God could do anything. He believed God could heal his pig. But his pig got sick. He believed God could heal his horse. His horse got sick. Brother Spidey said he'd call him out there a few times and said, Pastor, I need you to come out and anoint one of my animals. It's not doing too good. And he said, I knew he had enough faith to do it himself, but he wanted to come, so I couldn't tell him no. So I'd go out there with him, and I'd bring the oil, anoint oil, and he would ask me to anoint him, and I would anoint him. I'd be obedient. He said, it wasn't my faith, but it's old Brother Tom's faith. But sure enough, he said that whatever it was, a mule, a horse, a pig, whatever was sick, oh, we prayed for it, and sure enough, God would answer that prayer. God answers faith. Faith moves God. Amen. God will touch you. God will meet your need. God will bless you. God will answer your prayer. And this man needed prayer for some of his animals. Just like we prayed for Richard's dog today. Amen. They need that. They need the touch. Amen. We prayed for Mike Carroll's dog. Amen. And he's done amazing doctors. He's keeping on ticking. Praise God. That's right. And we're going to keep praying, keep believing God for it. But anyway, this man of God, he had kids. You know how kids are. If you tell them don't do something, they'll try their best to do it. Won't they? Amen on that. Anyway, he told kids not to climb the apple tree. And then one of his kids kept climbing. One of the boys climbed the tree. Amen. And fell out, broke his arm. And he said that that man of God had so much faith in prayer that he prayed for his son's arm. And it popped back in place. And completely healed. Didn't have to go to the doctor. Didn't have no pain, didn't have no problem. But his arm was healed. Amen. Now that's seeing the move of God there.
Amen.
Amen. God answers prayers. Now, I hope we don't have to pray for broken arms and legs and all that stuff. But God can take care of it. God can do it. Amen. Sister Glory, she's the answer to prayer right there.
Amen.
A lot of her bones were broken. God is touching her and heal her and bless her. And he's going to not quit till he's done, right? Praise God. But anyway, when old Tom would get all his family, get them out in the morning, get them back in, have to go go out and do those first chores and to come back in and let me go cut the breakfast, you know. Amen. That's back before they had the Cracker Barrel Country Boy breakfast, Brother Ellison. Ellison said, I don't need to talk about that Country Boy breakfast. We'll make it get back home. Praise God. Lord will, I'm going to take you out there, Brother Ellison, get you one of them, okay? Amen. Hold me to it. But anyway, you come back in there and you get all the family around the table. Of course, they pray and give thanks unto God. And old Brother Tom, after they eat, he'd get up, had his hat on, a nail up here on the wall, get that hat off, and he'd slap it against his legs and put that hat on his head and say, come on, youngins, let's put some legs on them prayers. Amen. Put some legs on them prayers. What does that mean? You need to walk the walk, talk the talk. Praise God. You got to keep going with God. It's harvest time. It's harvest time. Our prayers have been going up. We've done that part. We've sown to God. We're going to keep praying to God. And I tell you, it's time for harvest. He said, I'm going to call them from the south and the north and the south and the east and the west. I'm going to call them in. Praise God. We live in the greatest time, but we live in the greatest time that's ever been for evangelism. Because there's so much darkness. The Bible says, amen, where sin doesn't abound, grace does much more abound. Praise God. We are living in the greatest time to be a witness for the Lord. We're living in this greatest season, this Christmas season that's coming our way. We're living in a time that people are be going about. You know, they might not be thinking about the birth of Christ, but there are signs everywhere, light blinking. Praise God. Wonderful things, gifts being given. It gives us a great opportunity to be a witness for the Lord Jesus Christ. Praise God. That means, as I said earlier, Emmanuel, God is with us. God is with us. Hallelujah. That's in Matthew 1, 21, 23. His name shall be called Jesus. His name shall be Emmanuel. Jesus will save us from our sins. Emmanuel, God will be with us. With us. Praise God. Hallelujah. And see, amen, the darker the room, the darker the place, the darker the community, the brighter one little light. You get in a dark, dark room, light one little match, the light, amen, repels the darkness. The light will hold back the darkness. I'm telling you, we're going to let our light shine. You're going to let your light shine. You're going to do and be what God would have you to be. We're going to begin to disciple. We're going to see souls saved. I understand they tore down the Laurel's church, Brother Dave. They were going to track down. I don't know if they have yet. Do you know? One of the two boys told me that they were tearing it down. They were first going to leave it up, but they sold the church, closed it out, and they tear it down. That hurts my heart. That was the first church that I pastored. Brother David's pastored there. Been a lot of Brother Kenman pastored there. A lot of ministers have started their ministry from that church. But it tells me, I was telling my wife yesterday, you know, we're just one generation of closing this church there. We're just one generation. If our kids and our sons and our daughters and our neighbors and people in this generation, if we don't see them come to God, then it's over. Right? We don't want it to be over with. You don't want it to be over with. You've sent too many prayers up to God. And we know that God said it. We'll be willing. All we got to do is sow the seed. All we got to do is sow the seed and the harvest will come. Praise God. Glory to God. You see today, can I just tell you, this reminds you of this. We're not in this world to stay. We're just passing through. This world is not our home. We're just passing through. But while we pass through, we've got to share. We've got to tell people about Jesus. Somebody told you about Jesus. Somebody witnessed to you about the Lord. And now if we would clamp down and just forget and refuse to tell others about the saving grace of God, then we'll find ourselves in a generation, amen, that's lost and gone. But listen, praise God, God said it's not His will that anyone perish. God has never made anybody serve Him. God has never made anybody come to be a believer in Christ Jesus. But yes, He's loved you, wooed you, and pulled you. Amen. Loud conviction, songs, and testimonies to get a hold of your heart. Praise God. Amen. I want to leave a little thought with you. I want to sow a thought in your heart today. I want you to, I heard this week. I don't know for sure where I heard it or read it in a book. But this little thought said, make the Great Commission your last ambition. Make the Great Commission your last ambition. You see, we're just temporary residents here. And while we have opportunity, praise God, while we have opportunity, Jesus said, I give unto you power. Luke 10 and 19, I give unto you power to tread on serpents, scorpions, and all the power of the enemy. Amen. The devil is a real devil, but greater is He that's in us than he that's in the world. The devil, amen, does influence and does possess some people. Amen. But at the same time, Jesus said, go into all the world. Oh, God didn't say the whole world to come to church, but He did say the church ought to go to the whole world and tell them about the saving grace of God. I give unto you power. In Acts 1 and 8, He said, but you shall receive power after the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses unto me. Amen. Let's spend our key thought through this prayer time, these 8 weeks of prayer. We call it, the four pillars. He said, pray for Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and uttermost parts of the earth. We use those four pillars to pray, to keep us in the groove, praying, continue to remember back, thinking about Jerusalem being everything's local or church. Jerusalem, reaching out to our community, our leaders in the community, Samaria, all about the state and the other states in the southeast and even maybe the United States. And then Judea and Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and the uttermost parts of the earth. Pray for our missionaries along those things. But the Great Commission, there's a great commandment. What does it say? Love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, all thy soul, and all thy strength, and your neighbor as yourself. There's a great commandment, but there's also a great commission. Commission that the Lord Jesus Christ has commissioned us. Praise God. Commission means the power to authorize, to send on a mission. Commission means to power you, authority, give you the authority. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory to God. He knows it. Darn if I, He puts you under your rest, but hold up that badge. That badge is on it. He had the authority to pull you over. You see, but He wasn't big enough to do much of that. But He had the authority. And that authority is what stops you, right? Praise God. So we've got the authority. Jesus has given us the Great Commission, gives us, authorizes us, sends us on a mission. Go into all the world. Preach the gospel. Teach them, amen, the things that I've commanded you. Baptizing them in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. This word ambition. Make the Great Commission your life's ambition. This word ambition means to seek after earnestly. To seek after earnestly. To desire Wow, what's it all about? I've asked Mike to play a half a song. I want him to play a 2 minutes of a song that used to be a very popular song. It's entitled "People Need the Lord." I want him to play that right now. I want you to listen to it. If you're here today, you're not saved. Listen, you're on dangerous territory. The Lord's coming. The Lord's coming back. You'll be left there.